It must suffice.
Think of your cares if I'm clean.
The gentleman will refer to His Imperial Majesty by his full title or not at all. The gentleman will be seated on the bergère.
The what now?
In that chair. Cutwin, please shave the gentleman's sideburns to half an inch.
Always thought it added to my dignity.
It does. Yet it also detracts from your elegance. In Nilfgaard, we consider beards hard on the eyes. Especially beards infested with lice.
Been on the road a while. Fine. Do your thing.
Tilt your head back, please, and sit still.
And prepare to answer some questions.
General, I am not certain this is the appropriate time.
I can't think of a better time. Men turn honest when they feel a blade at their throat. Morvran Voris, commander of the Alba Division. Before they take you in to see the Emperor, Witcher, there's some information I need you to verify. It's a formality, but one that must be seen to.
Sure. Paperwork's gotta be in order.
So, Geralt of Rivia. Place of birth, unknown. Parents, unknown. Age, unknown. All insignificant details. Let us proceed to more recent events. The siege of La Valette Castle.
Arion escaped, set fire to the castle on his way out.
Ah. So that is how the blade started. Our reports suggested the dragon was responsible. Moving on.
Go on, next question, before my beard grows back in.
Imgrimi eb art kerzer. Dyfen aden in karn eb marvut. Emir var emreis.
Bow.
Your Imperial Majesty.
Arer ep the orde.
Avelian namen, vatgan favort. So many months at Foltest Court, yet you still haven't mastered the basics of etiquette.
Know what they say? Can't teach an old wolf new tricks. Take it you didn't summon me to reminisce about the good old days, so...
Silence. My daughter Cirilla, she's returned. And she's in danger. The Wild Hunt pursues her. Do you believe I'd drag you here in the middle of a war to discuss a rumor?
I think anyone can be wrong, even an emperor.
I had forgotten how insolent you can be. I haven't the time to convince you, nor the desire, in fact.
How many men in your army? 20,000? 30? So why me?
You know why. Because she trusts you.
She trusts me, yes. So tell me why you're looking for her. Doubt it's about making up for all those lost years.
For reasons of state, as always. Enough of this banter. You will agree regardless. If for no other reason than because I shall pay you. More than you customarily receive for a contract.
I need information, not motivation. Ciri leaves few tracks. She'll be hard to find.
My corps of spies will help you. Count on them, and my army, should the need arise. Yennefer will tell you the rest. This audience is finished. Meririd! Take him to the sorceress.
Geralt, that tunic. You look positively smashing.
Ugh, dying to take it off.
I'd consider that a proposition under different circumstances. One I might even take you up on. But we've matters to attend to. Now do you understand why I'm at Emir's court?
Mm-hmm. And seems we're in the same boat now. Ciri, she's really back? No chance he's mistaken?
Look. That's more or less what she looks like now. Or so our agents claim. Our little witch has grown into a young lady.
How about that? She's grown up.
It's been years since you trained together at Kaer Morhen. A great deal has changed.
You haven't. Not a bit.
I missed those awkward compliments of yours. But let's focus on Ciri, all right?
Right. Emir said the Wild Hunt's after her. I'd find that hard to believe before what happened yesterday. How did they track us down?
Because of me. You see, I've spent months searching for Ciri. Using locating spells, haruspicy, geomancy, anything, really. I knew the Wild Hunt might sense it, perhaps even find me, but I thought I'd tricked them.
Well, guess you were wrong.
I've sensed them on my trail, hunting me, for some time. If not for you and Emir's soldiers, they'd have gotten what they were after. I can't risk another encounter like that.
The Wild Hunt? What could it want from Ciri?
I've no clue, Geralt. Might have written them to ask, but I don't have their address. I know as much as you do. It must be about her blood.
So where's Ciri been seen, exactly?
In two places. Velen and Novigrad. The trail in Velen is most promising. You should make that your first stop. Ask for a merchant named Hendrik at the inn at the crossroads. One of the Emperor's agents. He should get in touch with you.
That's it? No passwords? Secret handshakes?
None. Sorry to spoil your fun. Your boyhood fantasies about the crafts of the trade. All we have in Novigrad are unconfirmed reports, rumors. But there you will have the help of our mutual acquaintance. Triss Merigold. Apparently she's got a cozy flat on the main square.
Sure she'll be delighted to see me. What about you? What will you do?
I shall sail for Skelliger. There was a magic explosion there recently, blew half a forest down. I believe this had something to do with Ciri. I'll be in Kaer Trold. Join me there once you've learned something.
One thing before we go. Why didn't you contact me? Didn't need me? Didn't even want to see me?
I didn't want to spoil things. I'd heard you and Triss made a great couple.
Yen, I'd lost my memory.
Really? That's your excuse? Let's drop it, all right? It's not what you think, or it helped me understand how much I love you. I don't wish to hear it. Any of it.
Guess this means we need to split up again. Not my preference, but I understand. Clock's ticking.
It is indeed. So why don't I teleport you to Velen, get you there at once?
Not gonna happen. I'll go on horseback, as soon as I can get changed.
Have it your way? Oh, and you really look quite dashing in black velvet.
Think so? Maybe I can have some of my armor lined with it. Good luck, Yen.
Same to you. And if you wish to learn what's happened in the world while you and Vesemir roam the wilderness, talk to Ambassador Vaartra. That's him over there. And Geralt, I know it's wartime, but try not to be a hero, all right? Just check those leads and come back to me, in one piece. I shall be waiting.
How do things look in Velen?
As bad as ever. Perhaps worse. This land never flowed with milk and honey, and now it flows with blood. Armies have swept through it several times, trampling fields, looting granaries, burning villages. Famine grips the populace.
So how's ruling that earthly paradise going for you?
Not well, to be honest. Our forces are spread thin as it is, and Velen is chiefly swampy forests that are difficult to control. We've had several patrols never return to their camps. Thus, we've temporarily delegated authority in this region to a certain Nordling, a former low-ranking officer in the Temerian army, one Philip Strenger, better known by his nom de guerre, the Bloody Baron. I advise you well. Avoid him.
When a humble bard graced a ride along with Geralt of Rivia, along came this song. From when the White Wolf fought a silver-tongued devil, his army of elves at his hooves did they revel. They came after me with masterful deceit, broke down my lute and they kicked in my teeth, while the devil's horns minced our tender meat. And so cried the Witcher, he can't be bleed. Toss a coin to your Witcher, O Valley of Plenty, O Valley of Plenty, oh. Toss a coin to your Witcher, O Valley of Plenty.
Looking for a barber? Well, you found one. Welcome. I'll plow and shave the gentleman's noggin for half price.
Give me a haircut. Long as your hands aren't too shaky. This is not what I wanted.
What do you mean, not what you wanted? Are you cut and coiffed? You are. And even can be, I'd say.
Thanks a bunch.
Pour me another, love.
You've had enough.
No wench will ration my vodka. Pour, dammit!
You gotta go.
Haven't finished my drink yet.
Innkeep, vodka.
Who's this un?
Brave warrior, looks like. Got two swords, see?
Oi, great boy. What's the point of having two swords?
Wonder if he keeps an extra prick in his trousers too.
How about I buy everybody around?
Why would you?
Got the coin for it. Simple as that.
I don't drink with strangers.
We share a round, won't be strangers anymore. Then we go our separate ways.
And which way might yours be? Bottoms up!
I'm looking for Hendrik.
Man lives in Heatherton.
Don't know where that is.
Other side of the hill. Looked that away this morning, saw a strange glow. Imperials on the raid, perhaps.
Be gone! Leave me be, whoever you is! Get away!
Calm down. It's over.
Aye. It's over. All's past, never to be restored. I'll not forget that ever.
Looking for a man named Hendrik, supposed to live in this village.
Aye, he did. No longer. They nabbed him in that hut. If you'd have heard the cries, sir. If you'd have heard how a man can scream.
Tell me what happened here, step by step.
They took him. Took them all. The sun was waning, see? And the dusk went crimson like blood. Thought to myself, strange. The toads, I cannot hear them. Through and through. Hendrik screamed.
Then he begged. By the end, he could do naught but moan. The terrors. Yet the village froze like in the heart of winter.
You in that hut when they rode off?
No, and I'll not set foot there. Never.
Farewell, and peace of mind to you. Tortured him. Maybe they missed something. Should check his boots. Blood. Congealed. Key hidden in his boot. Gotta fit a keyhole. Somewhere nearby, hopefully. There's a draft. Gotta be a space under this rubble. Guess I should do some cleaning. A ledger. Payment for a sack of grain. Amount due for a charcoal shipment. Hendrik was masquerading as a merchant. What's this? Notes among the ledger entries. Clever. Interesting headings. Don't know by whom or why. Somehow they learned Hendrik was looking for Ciri. Thus the torture. I'm too late. My only leads, the Baron, and some witch. Damn. Baron home?
Depends who's asking.
A witcher. Wanna talk to him.
Huh. Yeah. And I wanna plow the lovely Queen Ceril.
Seen this man before. In at the crossroads. You brought us around.
Lodrin, let him in. If he makes any trouble, well, we outnumber him.
Open the gate. Sergeant! Ardal! Witcher, to see the Baron. Don't want no disturbances.
How we danced! How we twirled!
Ooh!
1, 2, 3! 1, 2, 3! Hey!
Enough. I don't care how you do it, but the deliveries must be weekly.
Won't you stay for tea?
No. Besides, you've another guest.
Look at that. Didn't even stay for tea. In spite of all that blabbering about how cultured the nation is, I know who you are. Believe I also know why you've come. A snifter?
Why not?
Ha! A man after my own heart. With Foltes dead and Natalis whereabouts unknown. Bloody hell, who's a loyal Temerian to drink to these days?
Himself and his company?
Good enough. To the matter at hand, I'm Philip Strenger. Now the Blobtits round here call me the Bloody Baron.
Geralt of Rivia. Blobtits call me the Butcher of Blaviken.
I said already, I know who you are. Truth be told, it's the only reason we're talking. How do you like it here in Velen?
Swamps, bogs, marshes everywhere.
Exactly. Someone loses their way round here. He becomes damn hard to find.
What are you getting at?
Many have lost loved ones here. Some their wives, others their daughters.
That a threat?
Aye, not as clever as I suspected you'd be. Now it's no threat. I'll spell it out for you. I know who you're looking for. She showed up some time ago. Exhausted, wounded, and stinking like a soaked hound after a hard hunt. Later, I learned she'd come from the swamp.
Hello there. Are you lost?
A little, I guess. Are you?
I never lose my way.
Ooh. If that's true, what are you doing so deep in the forest alone?
Looking for lost little girls.
What happened to you?
This? It's nothing. How did you wind up here?
My father brought me. Told me to follow the trail of treats and eat my fill. He said he would wait. So I started down the trail, but then I saw a butterfly, and I ran to catch it, and I lost my way.
Your father, why did he have you follow the trail of treats? Do you know?
Because we had nap to break our fast with.
I don't understand.
I was naughty. Broke a jug. Spilled all our milk.
Your parents must have been angry.
Mother said I should be spanked, but Father said wouldn't do no good. Too many mouths to feed anyway. Sending me down the trail of treats, that would solve things.
When did you leave home?
This morning.
And did the sun warm your face or your back?
It warmed my back.
So we must go east.
Look! There's something there.
Wait here. Don't come any closer.
But...
No buts. Stay here. I must see something.
What happened to him?
He had a fall.
I bet. The Wolf King got him.
When did children get so smart?
What will we do when the Wolf King finds us?
Good question.
What?
The Wolf King! Now do you believe me?
I do! Hide!
Just who do you think you've brought me, man? That's not me daughter.
And the little one?
Neither, dammit! I think I'd know my own child.
Well, it might not be yours, the older one, but you've got to admit the likeness. That's downright striking. So, any chance for that reward?
You'll not see one fucking copper. Get out before I set my hounds on you. So I ordered my men to watch her, and left her to rest.
And?
Ah, a topic for another time.
The little girl who showed up here with Ciri, what happened to her?
Gretka. She's safe and sound, helps out in the kitchen. Ciri told me of the girl's parents, what they decided. So I decided not to send the lass home. She's fed here. A roof over a warm corner she calls her own. She wants for nothing.
What happened to Ciri?
I've told you already. A topic for another time.
No, a topic for now. Talk.
That sharpness. What's your tone, Witcher? We wish to come to an agreement, do we not? Sharp you are. I regret your loss. Commiserate. But you see, it so happens my wife and daughter are missing as well. I propose an exchange. Find my loved ones, and I shall tell you about the girl you seek.
Fine. I'll help you. I'll find your family, but then you'll give me every bit of information you have.
You have my word. Guard! This man's under my protection. No one's to bother him in any way. Don't stare. I've not grown horns. Treat it as a token of my good faith.
When do you see them last?
They vanished after the new moon, as if whisked away by shadows.
What do you mean, vanished?
Precisely that.
You try to search for them?
Sent men out right away, but they're not suited to it. It's one thing to rip up floorboards in search of a peasant's last sack of grain. finding a living person. They just don't know how. Besides, Velen's naught but swamps and marshy woodland. Plenty of hard to find nooks. If you're looking to hide someone, this is the place.
This place? Must be hard to be the only two women here.
This place? What do you mean? I wanted for nothing here. Pheasant for dinner, not a problem. Blue ribbons from Toussaint, say the word.
Had your men in mind. Their company. Sure your wife and daughter weren't being harassed?
My men are a horde of horsens, but they know their place.
They act differently, do anything strange?
Unusual? No. Well, not long ago, peasants came to complain that a beast had ravaged a woman by the well, devoured another lass before her. Common occurrences in Velen. And my women, Anna, quiet as a mouse as ever, and Tamara, occupied with her things.
I'll need to know a lot more than that. Can I see their rooms?
What for?
I need clues. Anything to latch onto.
I'll not let a stranger pour through their belongings.
Want me to find them or not?
I do.
It gets interesting. Piece of wood looks like the stem of that candlestick. Found signs of a fight in the room. Know anything about that?
A fight? What are you talking about?
Someone was attacked. Probably your wife or daughter. Whoever it was tried to defend themselves with a candlestick. Missed the attacker. Punctured the wall instead. They tussled too.
I don't know nothing about this. That night, I was drunk. Don't remember a thing. They were gone by the time I awoke.
Recognize this amulet?
Yes. Anna began wearing it a time ago.
Any idea where she got it?
None.
Any witches or cunning women in the area?
A Pella. Old Coot lives near Blackbow. And there's a cunning woman in Midcops, but I know little about her. She's only recently arrived. If Anna were to see someone, she'd choose the Pella, not the woman.
Ought to have a chat with this Pella.
Fair warning, he's a hard man to talk to. Rumor has it he killed his own father with an axe as a lad, then went batty. Now they say he sees ghosts and plows his goat.
Not really interested in his hobbies. Just want to ask about the amulet. Hey, anybody home? I need your help.
Ooh, a man. Nay, a wolf. Grey, though not old. 'Tis he the Pella awaits. Aye, as the bones declared I should. They shall come whose stench is rape and death, but the wolf shall disperse them, the white wolf. And thus he comes. Omens never lie.
Recognize this? Made of spruce wood, strong smell of juniper, designed to protect someone.
Freshly cut spruce, sprinkled with goat's blood, then tempered with an incense of earth, smoke, and juniper. For Anna. To protect her.
Anna and her daughter are missing. Know where they are?
Nay. No. Nay. Pella don't know. But the spirits could know. The Pella will augur, the spirits ask.
Spirits. Great. Fine with me. Long as I know where to look, where to find them.
Lost. Lost. Must be found. Princess! None better than princess for finding things.
Princess? Which princess?
Princess! My goat! She's fled!
Those men must have scared her off. Can we get back to the auguring?
Without the goat? Impossible. No goat? Won't work.
Getting on my nerves, old man. I'm not going anywhere.
No princess, no prophecy, no augury.
Can't seriously think I'm gonna chase down your
goat of mine! Dearest, sweetest goat!
Can we talk about Anna and Tamara now? Know where they might be?
Blood. We need blood. A living being.
Fine. Be right back. Will this do?
That is it.
Spirits had nothing more to say? Like where they went or where they are now?
You came for an augury, and augur I did.
Anna was pregnant?
She was. And she miscarried.
Baron didn't mention it.
Afraid, perhaps. Or ashamed, or forgetful. Or perhaps he had no wish to remember.
What happened to the child?
In a grave thrown. Without rite or ceremony, it awoke. Now it wanders. It seeks vengeance.
A botchling.
White wolf, wise wolf, catch the botchling. The botchling will help. Lead the wolf to the loved ones.
Botchlings suck the blood of pregnant women and eat their fetuses. They don't help.
'Tis a being cursed, and witches lift curses. If the white wolf can't lift it, he should bring me its blood.
Heard of one witcher who lifted a botchling's curse. Never tried it myself, though. I know you need to bury it under the threshold.
And give it a name. Perform the I'm Roin.
The ritual of naming? That's an elven custom.
Human, elven, dwarven, ancient. Spirits have no race. They honor not its meaning. Win a spirit's favor, and the spirit shall aid you. Ask, and it will answer. Seek, and it will show you the way.
If what you say is true, the Baron ought to know where that grave is.
Oswin! Where's Oswin? Anyone seen him?
Believe I saw him heading to the stable.
What?
Fire. You blind? Nobody willing to put it out?
Ha 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 ha! We've a hero in our midst. You've earned yourself a barrel of Lyrian.
I know your wife miscarried. Was that before or after you beat her to a pulp?
What the fuck are you suggesting?
We need to talk. Sit down. You beat them.
I never laid a finger on Tamara. Not once.
And on Anna?
That's another story.
Expect me to believe you are a loving father to Tamara after that scene in the courtyard?
You're free to believe whatever you wish, but she was always the apple of my eye. She had the run of the place. Ask anyone. She'd ride the horses, hunt with the men, at times join them on their rounds. And they'd send for her when I flew into a rage, for only she could calm me.
You knew they had run away from the start?
Yes, I knew.
Why didn't you tell me? Wasted my time.
Say I had. Say I'd said I had troubles. Couldn't control my wife, my daughter. What kind of flaccid prick would you take me for?
Tell me everything you remember about the day they fled. The truth this time.
I'd been soaking myself 3 days straight. Anna came to me, said they were leaving. I begged them to stay. She refused to hear it. I tried to stop her. She wriggled like an eel. We struggled. She fell. Last blasted thing I remember. Woke up in the morn, breeches heavy with my own piss. A large bump on my head. Sadly, they were gone. Know what that's like, Witcher? No. How the fuck could you? I was left with nothing. Nothing! Only the bottle.
Hole in the wall, wine all over the landing. Was that you?
Oi, we tussled. She tried to whack me on the noggin with a candlestick, but kept missing. Hit the wall and the pillar instead. I staggered backwards onto the table, spilled the wine, slipped and tumbled. Anna used that moment to flee. She rushed down the stairs, still clutching that damn candlestick. I caught her on the landing. We fell. I thought I had her. Then she turned and smacked me in the head.
What happened next?
Next? It only got worse. I awoke at sunset, not knowing how many days had passed. Thought it was all a ploughing, drunken nightmare. And then I went to the bedchamber. But Anna was not there. Instead, there was blood everywhere. I knew she'd miscarried. My breath short, my throat locked. I neared the bed and saw it. It lay there, a tiny thing, defenseless, on bloodied sheets, dead. And it was my doing.
Seen a lot of dead in my time, but that must have been hard.
Unspeakably so. My legs gave out. I saw fields of corpses at Sodden. Saw witches burn in Maribor. But compared to this, all that was a rabbit's prick alongside a great oak. And the guilt is all mine.
We don't know that yet. The amulet Anna wore could be linked somehow. Maybe the fact that she lost it. What did you do with the child?
Wrapped it in a clean sheet and buried it.
Just like that?
Damn you! I gave no thought to a funeral. It was a horror. I wanted it to end. That child had been my dream. I told Anna, the little one, our little one, to make things right. Yet she died before she could be born.
I sympathize. I do.
Thank you. And know that I hope you find your Ciri.
Deal we made means I need to find Tamara and Anna first. Just so happens your unborn daughter might help us do that.
What? How?
Sometimes miscarried fetuses, if they don't get a proper burial, turn into botchlings.
Into fucking what?
A cursed creature that draws strength from killing pregnant women. Once it's strong enough, it attacks those who scorned it.
But how? How does it know?
Blood ties. They're a strong bond. A bond I want to use to find your family.
How?
One of two ways. Legends claim you can bury a botchling under the family's threshold, perform a ritual, and turn it into a lubberkin. That's a sort of, hob. A guardian spirit that could lead me to your family.
And the other way?
We kill it and draw some blood. Take that to the Peller and he does the rest.
Do not kill my child. It's suffered enough already. Lift the curse that it may finally rest in peace.
Whatever we do, we gotta find the botchling first.
I'll show you where I buried her.
Chose a lovely spot.
Damn it, will you relent? I'm ploughing now I've done wrong.
Good. The grave's dug up and empty.
What's that mean?
Botchling's on the prowl.
Look! It'll bite us in the arse before we know it!
Keep screaming and it will turn rabid. It's calm for now.
Bloody hell! What happens when it gets ploughing restless?
It'll bite through your jugular, and you'll bleed to death before I can help. Tell me if it starts wriggling. I'll calm it with magic. Pick it up. Take it in your arms.
merciful gods! What now?
Repeat after me. By the powers of earth and sky.
By the powers of earth and sky.
By the world that was to be your home.
By the world that was to be your home.
Forgive me, you who came, but who I did not embrace.
Forgive me, you who came, but who I did not embrace.
I name thee, say her name, and embrace thee as my daughter.
I name thee, Daya, and embrace thee as my daughter.
Good. Now bury the body. Should turn into a lubberkin. I'll stay here and wait. You go home.
I'll wait with you.
Out of the question.
But that's my child. And the guilt, the responsibility for all this lies with me.
Time for parental impulses? It's long past. Besides, nothing else you can do here.
But...
No buts. Just Witcher's work left to do here. Gotta wait a day and a night for the botchling to turn into a lubberkin. That's it. Go home. And try not to drink yourself stupid again.
By blood's power, I summon you. With your name, I beseech you. Hear my call and arise, Daya.
Lead me to those bound to you by blood.
Who's that? At the room. Go on now.
What you seek here, sir? Our hut's out of the way. Woeful. We has nothing. We knows nothing.
Just need information. Looking for two women, the Bloody Baron's wife and daughter.
Not a soul have been here, sir.
Sure, not even passing through. Daughter's medium height, about 20. Her mother's thin, about 40. Seen them?
Sorry, sir, but you don't look like one of her father's men.
Because I'm not. I'm looking for Tamara and her mother. I need to know if they're alive and safe.
Tamara is, aye. She's to my brother's place in Oxenford. But Mrs. Anna, that's another tale.
What happened to Tamara's mother?
Twere like this. I was awaiting in the old smokehouse with horses. Cold as hell and so dark, couldn't see past two elves in front of ye. Moon had risen high, and still they hadn't come. Began to fear some demon had snatched them. But finally, they came forth, and we sets off towards the river. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a gale arose. Thought it'd tear my head off. And those damn birds, swarms of them coursing o'er the woods, raising a racket to make your ears bleed.
Fine. What happened next?
Grew even darker. Seemed someone had put out the stars. Crickets all went silent of a sudden. And then, from the woods, a roar. Broke out in a cold sweat, and before I could catch my breath, a beast jumped out of the woods, big as a barn, with horns and two burning coals for eyes. I thought I was done for. Beast attacked Mrs. Anna's horse, ripped its head off, carried her off into the woods. Our horses, mine and Miss Tamara's, got spooked and tore off willy-nilly. T'were the only reason we escaped. The miss wanted to go back for her mother. But my wife pleaded, said she'd die out there alone.
Why help them at all? You risked a lot.
I'd a debt. Owed Miss Tamara. 3 moons passed, a fever gripped my boy. We thought he was done for. Tamara learnt it. Brought food and salves. We're poorer than dirt itself. She saved my boy. No two ways about it. Me, myself, I'd have never dared to help. But my missus told me a time of war and contempt's come, a time of folk gone wrong. We needs to repay good with good. Who stands by idly does evil as if.
Married a wise woman. Thanks for your help. So here our paths diverge. Thank you, Dea. Go in peace. There you are.
See the hollyhock there? The violet blooms. Brought the plants here from Nazaire. Anna had read some story. Insisted on having them. Spent hours tending to them, trimming, pruning. She was so content at that. And them, the frilly ones, are called birds of paradise in Zeracania. But Tamara called them dragons of paradise.
Your loss, it must hurt bad. But there wasn't anything we could do.
No, not now, not anymore. It was too late, that was clear. Should have acted earlier, taken them all from this damned Velen. In this hole, this reasty mire, nothing could go right here.
Got some information about your family.
You've learned something? Well, let's go inside. It's a bit chilly out.
Your daughter's in Oxenfurt.
What the blazes? She all right? In good health? Safe? Why haven't you brought her back?
Never offered to do that.
How do you know she's safe? You see her at least?
No, but I talked to the man who helped her escape and then took her in. Tamara is safe and sound.
Well, what are you waiting for?
For you to tell me about Ciri, like we agreed.
Fine. A word once given. When Ciri was on the mend, we took her out on a hunt.
Not bad. Not bad at all. But who goes boar hunting with a sword?
No bow at hand, no spear. My sword was all I had.
Well, you brandished it beautifully.
I learned from the witches there.
Know any of them potions?
Not so much. A bit.
Because you see, at times I get this pinching back here.
Shut it, Ygrin. Nobody cares about your backside. A woman could swing a sword, I've knowed one, but never seen a lady mount anything but a cock proper. All tipsy on horseback, nothing strange on account they bloody mount them sideways.
Perhaps you'd care to wager?
Think you can outrun me on an horse? Naturally. What's the stake?
Black mare. The one in the stable.
Oh, that won't do at all. The horse is mine.
To race the Baron himself, I'd consider it an honor.
Oh, that'd be a sight to behold.
Would it ever?
Done. But if I win, I take your sword.
Agreed.
I'd not drink any more this night. You'll want your head about you. We start at daybreak. Day dawns.
Ready?
As ever. First one to the tower.
Man chop!
What?
Another chance to win.
She screamed like a mad woman. In an instant, all had forgotten the wager. Every man ran to save his skin, even worried to break his neck.
And they make it?
Some, aye. Others were not so fortunate. But what happened then? I must say, Witcher, seen a lot, but nothing like this. Never.
Uh-oh. I know that look.
You're a fast learner. You'll know the rest once you find my wife.
Working on it.
And making piss-poor progress.
They split up. Hadn't considered that possibility before. But don't worry, I'll find Anna too.
Wait, Witcher! When you find my daughter, will you give her this?
I'm looking for Tamara, the Bloody Baron's daughter. Your brother said I'd find her here.
Vojtek sent you, sir.
How else would I know she was here?
Wait a moment. I'll fetch her straight away.
You're looking for me, and who might you be? My father sent you?
Yeah, to see if you're still alive, and well. I'm Geralt of Rivia.
I'm quite alive and extraordinarily well, Geralt of Rivia. Better than I've ever been in this rotten life of mine, and now that you've seen me, I bid you farewell.
Wait.
We've nothing more to talk about.
Your father's a vile man. You're angry and bitter. Can't blame you.
Why do you help him then? Why did you take this job?
Because he knows something about someone dear to me. Promised to tell me if I found you and your mother.
Got it. A bit of blackmail. Just his style.
Before I agreed to look for you, your father told me his version of events. Tell me yours.
Mine? It's dull as life amidst the swamps. My earliest memories are of a drunken father lying under the stairs, caked in mud and clutching a bottle. Next dozen years, pretty much the same. Father would drink, disappear for days, then come home in a rage and send furniture flying. Thank the gods for war. I was glad every time they sent him off. And the quarrels. I remember him screaming at Mum, the thuds as he beat her, then her sobbing. I'd hide under my bed and long for silence. That's the long and short of it. Multiply by 19, and there you have my life.
I don't mean to pry, but I know your mother had a miscarriage.
His doing? He shoved her, she fell, that's how it started. We were alone, no one to help, blood everywhere. Worst night of my life.
Sorry. Must have been hard for you both.
Mum was in shock. She was raving that it was better this way, that she never wanted the child. She must have had a fever. She was losing blood the whole time.
Vojtek claims your mother had strange marks on her hands and that a monster dragged her into the woods. That true?
We were riding towards the river. Suddenly, Mum cried out, bent over, almost fell off her horse. I rode up to her and saw something strange. Her hands were on fire. And then that creature leapt from the woods. I don't know what it was, but it roared so fierce my nose bled. I saw it topple trees. I've never been so scared in my life. And that thing grabbed my mum and disappeared into the woods. I wanted to turn back, go after them, but the horses panicked.
What will you do now?
Find my mum.
You realize that might not be that easy.
Don't worry, I'm not daft enough to believe I can do it alone. I've got some new friends now. Powerful friends.
Who are these friends, if it's not a secret?
No secret. Heard of the Church of the Eternal Fire? A priest helped me contact the Redanian witch hunters. Righteous, brave men. They'll help me.
Hence the candlesticks in your room. So you believe in the Eternal Fire?
Once the heat of the fire has set your heart aflame, it gives you strength and leads you down the path of truth for the rest of your life.
What about your father?
Who? Oh, him. I don't care. I won't go back to him. That bit of my life? Forgotten it already.
Well, well. A witcher. Never thought the Baron would stoop to hiring a monster slayer. Though I hear you're good at tracking things down.
Desperate fathers have been known to do a lot to find their daughters.
Unexpected from a witcher. I thought your mutations cleansed you of humanity.
Glad you know who I am. Haven't introduced yourself, though.
Gradin, witch hunter in the service of His Royal Majesty Radovid of Redania. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Rings a bell.
If the Bloody Baron sent you to fetch his daughter, you'd best face it. You will fail in your task.
I appreciate your concern, but I don't need it. As for Tamara, she can make her own decisions. Where are you going to take her?
Tamara must rest. She's had a harrowing experience. When the warmth of the Eternal Fire has restored her strength, we shall see about finding her mother.
Before you go, your father asked me to give you this.
Clara? Father told you to give me Clara. funny how he thought to buy me back with a memory. Tell him one gesture could never make up for a ruined childhood. So long, Witcher. In spite of all, I'm grateful you gave me a choice. Didn't force me to go back to the tyrant.
Hope you know what you're getting yourself into. So long, and good luck.
When a humble bard graced a ride along with Geralt of Rivia, along came this song. From when the White Wolf fought a silver-tongued devil, his army of elves at its hooves did they revel. They came after me with masterful deceit, broke down my lute, and they kicked in my teeth.